Hello, and welcome to Whovian Reviewing, Episode 0. Welcome to the very first episode of the very first podcast brought to you by the Vacuuminator Network. I am your host, the Vacuuminator, and you are listening to Whovian Reviewing Episode 0. And I am joined today by my co-hosts,
Bill
and Ben.
You may be wondering what Whovian Reviewing is. Well, Whovian Reviewing is the first podcast of its kind. Yes, I checked. Whovian Reviewing, this is the first podcast of its kind and the first podcast done by the Vacuuminator Network, as previously stated. In this podcast, we will be reviewing every episode of Doctor Who, the Revived series, as well as the spin-offs and a few from the classic series, which that's Bill's responsibility. Isn't it, Blackie?
Called you a lackey.
Would you define that, please?
Slave.
Works for me.
For no money.
Just for that, I'm putting a virus in your next audio that I'm sending you. Yes, that will be my responsibility. I tend to think of myself as more the historian of the group.
Yes, Phil has seen the most of the Revived series out of the three of us. I myself have seen about 20, 25 episodes.
I've seen about 2, so... I've seen Genesis of the Daleks, and I think it was Genesis of the Daleks, and The Five Doctors, but they're good episodes.
Yeah, I could count off all my classic series episodes I've seen, but I'd just be standing here for 20 minutes saying, this is what I thought of this episode, this is what I thought of this episode.
And, which is what we're technically supposed to be doing anyways.
We're here to talk about the Five series.
Yeah, well.
That's what the show is mainly going to be focused on.
Yes, and...
So we're starting out with...
I'm sorry, say again, Bill?
We're starting off with Rose, correct, from the first season?
Yes, we're starting from the first season and going all the way up until current.
Well, yes. But we're starting with Rose.
If we get to... Sorry.
It's basically just, if you're trying to get into Doctor Who and you're a bit intimidated by, I jump on now... and I'm going to not understand a lot of the plot points, well, you can play catch-up with us.
Yeah, we'll basically be explaining, you know, the backstory of Doctor Who, what he is, who he is. That may be our first episode, just explaining who the Doctor is, and then explaining the first episode of the revised series. But I believe you said we were doing episode 1, 2, and 3, or was it just episode 1?
I think it was one, two, episodes and 1, 2, and 3 in episode 1, and I would eventually like to have a special episode just called Doctor Who 101.
That's fine.
We should do that.
Would you rather do that one first, or would you rather just jump right into the first episode?
Just jump right into the first episode, of course.
Very good.
By the way, I need to watch that.
We might be able to get special guests if we're lucky. Oh, that might be a very...
Yes, we're hoping to do interviews somewhere down the line.
Maybe not interviews, just like people who are also fans of the show who are also big on the internet. Well, not big, but they have a fan base.
Yes, it would be freaking awesome if we could get JT Mitchell 87 or Lynn Carr on for an episode.
Yeah, people like that. Bill has no idea who they are because he doesn't have a persona on the internet. Bill, would you like to elaborate on that?
In my line of work, it is beneficial to remain anonymous.
But your name is on the internet now. We're in a podcast.
Are you sure it's my real name?
Basically, how the show is going to work is Series 1 of this show is going to be Doctor Who Series 1, a TARDIS time episode, which that's our name for the episodes where we're going to be reviewing episodes of the classic series, and Torchwood Series 1. And then in Series 2 of the podcast, we will have, I think, two TARDIS time episodes, as well as we'll be adding in the Sarah Jane Adventures to our roster of shows to review.
I have not seen an episode of Torchwood before, by the way.
I have not either, and I'm not...
None of us have.
Personally, it hasn't struck me as a very good show. But that's just from what I've read.
Yes, quote Nash, basically the best way to sum Torchwood up is, happy, fun, sci-fi, sexy time!
Agree.
Yeah, I have seen a episode of Sarah Jane Adventures. Just the other day, I went to track down the episode where Matt Smith shows up.
I haven't seen that episode, so I'm going to have to get on that.
That's a good episode. Yeah,
it was a...
It has Grant in it as well, which was John Pertwee's companion before Sarah Jane.
Who? Joe?
That's the second episode, second Doctor, isn't it?
Third. That was the third Doctor's companion before Sarah Jane.
Patrick Troughton, sorry.
No, it was John Pertwee's companion.
Now, who was the second Doctor then?
Patrick
Troughton.
Yeah.
There we go.
But she was John Pertwee's companion.
Back to the show's overall form.
Yeah. I may be doing some Doctor Who book reviews, because lately I've been reading the Doctor Who books, or I've read one. But maybe we could incorporate that into it.
Yes, and if I get the figures, which I'm hoping to get some more of the figures, at the moment all I have is the Flight Control TARDIS, which is a very nice little piece. But if I do get some of the figures, I would like to do audio versions of my reviews of that.
Well, really, we could just say, we've made a review of the Doctor Who, what was it, the TARDIS, sorry?
Flight Control TARDIS.
Yeah, you could just say we've made a review, or Vacuuminator has made a review of the Flight Control TARDIS. Check it out on the Vacuuminator at youtube.com.
Yeah.
And then you could do a video review.
Yeah, that sort of thing. That's what we're planning on. That's what we're going to do. Yeah.
We might have a Q&A session, maybe, if you guys want to send in Q&A or Qs, and we'll answer them.
Yes. And, if I do end up... Don't you dare make the Koopa Q joke.
No, I said we will A your Qs, so we will answer your questions. We'll A your Qs, and it just sounds weird.
Okay. But, yes, and I am somewhat planning on getting a second webcam, so maybe we could do some episodes live over Ustream.
How could we do a three-way Ustream video thing, or will we have three?
You can, but it would be tremendously laggy. You would hear something like a minute after I said it.
We might just.
I would just have a camera shooting for Ustream and a camera for Skype, and I would leave my headphones unplugged.
Right. The reason for the show is because we like Doctor Who.
Yes, we are free nerds with not enough time to waste, so we're making a podcast.
Oh, I've got time to waste.
No, it means... Oh, that...
We've got too much time on our hands.
What I meant was basically, we have time to waste, so we decided to do a podcast.
Yeah. Well, you want to do a podcast, but that's a story for another time.
Yes, I wanted to do... I was the person with the idea for the podcast, and I just kind of dragged Bill into it, and Ben said, why not? And any overall, sort of... Would you guys like to talk about your overall relationship with the show, how you got into it, how you became a fan, that sort of thing?
I think we could do that for another time. Or do you think we could do it now, or...?
Yes, we need to do it in episode 0 just to get it out of the way.
I'm not terribly sure I want to do that, thank you very much. You can skip me. You know, I wanted to say, to point out, that I am in no way addicted to the teleprompter. Pause. Smile.
I don't have a teleprompter. Oh, I just got the joke. Anyway. Oh, we have a theme tune.
Hey, yeah, bye, yes, we do. I am the song, Simeon.
I should talk about that fear in another episode, that how Doctor Who villains actually scare me.
The only one that I ever had problems with was Blink.
That freaked me out. I couldn't sleep. I had to, like, look and make sure there was no angel in my room. And I was, like, 15, 16.
I have an overactive imagination at times, so that, yeah, I have a problem with that.
Mm. I've never been scared of anything that's been on Doctor Who. The villains freaked me out at first, but then I was like, it's fiction. The overall format of the show will consist of, we will come in, give you an update on what we've been doing lately, not very personal, we'll just say like, oh, this was interesting, this happened to me recently. We'll start with playing a bit of some audio from an episode, then we'll come back, Bill will paraphrase the Wikipedia article for that episode. We'll give our notes, and then one of us will give our overall thoughts on the episode.
Beforehand, I'll read the Wikipedia article and correct any errors that there are there, and then read what I have, because I don't trust Wikipedia.
Yeah. Yes. no one trusts Wikipedia. We'll just basically do about anywhere from 2 to 5 episodes per episode of the show, depending on how much time we have and what episodes I have slated, because I'm, aside from TARDIS time episodes, I'm in charge of saying, we do this, this, and this this week.
And then unless we're adding certain things, maybe. Maybe I'll say, can we do this episode of the specials? Specials happen.
Yeah. Or supplementals.
Hey, Ben, I thought we mutiny.
And books. Sorry, Ben?
I thought we mutiny.
Mutiny, yes.
Just because.
We're taking over the show in the first episode, which isn't the first episode, because it's the episode zero.
So, now that Ben and I have control of the episode, I vote we nominate Simeon as the director.
Yay!
We vote Simeon as the director, sure.
Yeah, now that we've taken over.
Yay!
Now we've taken over, yeah. So we're the leaders, but he's the director, so...
Yeah, so we lead.
We know our place.
We lead, but he tells us what to do.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's pretty much it for this episode of Who Be In Reveal, don't you think, guys?
I would say yes.
Yeah, we've been filming for quite a long time, and you know what? It'll probably average out to about 15 minutes, so that's not long, but long enough.
Yeah. Well, thank you for watching this episode of Movie and Reviewing. I have been the Vacuuminator. We're joined by my co-hosts,
Bill
and Ben.
We hope you will be joining us next time, where we will be reviewing Rose, The End of the World, and The Unquiet Dead. And be sure to follow us on Twitter. My Twitter is @Vacuuminator. Ben, what is your Twitter?
I currently don't have a Twitter for my internet usage, if that makes any sense. I do have
a personal Twitter. Has a personal Twitter at the moment, but we promise by the next episode, Ben will have a proper Twitter to link you guys to. Be sure to give us some feedback on the show. Please leave your feedback in iTunes as a review. You can also subscribe to us on YouTube. My YouTube username is VacuumNS, spelled VacuumNA. Ben, what is your YouTube?
My YouTube account is called BoulderMan2010, spelt wrong. It doesn't have a U in it, so it's BoulderMan2010. Reason it's not spelt right, long story. I actually explain it on my channel, so you can see it there.
And until next time, this has been the Vacuuminator, joined by his overlords, and we will see you next time.